Hi everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how I sketch exercise 2.1 sketch number 2. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to look at this image that I have right here, and I'm going to be sketching the front view, I'm going to be sketching the right side view, and I'm going to be sketching a top view of this object. And so what I want to do is count the grids as I do this. And so in my front view, if I start at this corner, which I'm going to take this corner and I'm going to begin it right here at that corner on my sketch. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Start at that corner, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I'm going to put a dot right there. I'm going to draw the bottom, and that line right there represents this edge there on my sketch. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to start at this corner and measure up. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to come to the corresponding corner, go up 1, 2, 3, 4. That would be that corner there, would be at the end of that line. I'm going to go to the opposite side over here and count 1, 2, 3 grids. Go up 1, 2, 3. At that corner there, that would be the corresponding corner there. Now, I want to go to this point next from here, so I'm going to be drawing across like that. If I measure along the x-axis, which is right here, I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 grids on the x, and then I'm going to go up 1 on the y. So I'm going to do that over here. I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 on the x, go up 1 on the y, and connect those points together, and that gives me that inclined line that I have right there. Now at that point, here's where I'm located at in my sketch. I can see that this goes straight up 2, so I'm going to go up 1, up 2. It comes across 1, I'm going to come across 1. It comes down 1, goes across 2, goes up 1, comes across 1, and goes down 1. So starting right here, I'm going to go down 1, across 2, up 1, across 1, down 1. And at that point, I'm at this location right here. I'm at the bottom of this vertical line, which would correspond to that point. I already know where this point is, so I'm going to connect the dots. And that's the shape for my front view right there. Now I've got a couple of other things that I'm going to have to add here, and those are going to be some holes and some hidden lines. So let's look at the hole on this. I have a hole that is 1/2 grid from the center over to here, 1/2 grid from the center over here, which means if I add those together, the diameter of this hole is 1 grid. Same with this over here. The location of the center of that hole, if I start at this corner, I would measure 2 on the x, 2 on the y, that would give me the center. So I'm going to start at that corner, measure over 2, go up 2, and at that point right there, I'm going to draw a plus for a center mark. On the opposite side, if I start at this corner and I measure over 2 and I sketch up 2, so starting here I'm going to sketch over 2, sketch up 2. At that point I would put a center mark in, and then I'm going to draw a circle, and I want that circle's diameter to be as wide as one of these grids right here. So if I go about halfway away from that point right there, and then I draw a circle that goes through those, and I'm just sketching, it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to go about a half a grid from that center. I'm going to sketch. Okay, so that represents the two holes that go through my part. Now I said there were some hidden lines on this view, and if I'm looking in this direction right here, I want you to look in this area here and here. Well, of course, I don't see anything on the front surface on this plane, but behind that, there's a plane that runs behind this feature right here. And I would actually see a hidden line there and a hidden line here that I need to add to my view. So that's going to lie up here on this plane. So I'm going to draw a little dash. I'm going to have a break. I'm going to draw another dash. I'll do the same thing over here. I'll draw a dash and another dash, and there's the hidden line in that view. Now usually what we do with center lines is we want to bring them out about a quarter inch past the edge of our circle, like that. So the rule sort of is come out about a quarter inch past the edge of of the feature that they're the center of. Okay, so as you can see, I have my front view is finished. So I'm going to come up here and work on my top view. The top view, if I start at this corner and I count over 1, 2, 3, 4, that's how deep the top view is. So I'm going to start my top view at this corner here. And so I'm going to come straight down 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how wide the top view is going to be. Now, the width of the top view, if I start sketching across here, how do I know where to end that line? Well, because it's a projection of my top view, if I just were to draw a light construction line up to that point right there, I would want to bring that line all the way to there. The back edge would be the same distance. So I'm going to sketch that across to there. And then I'm going to bring this line forward. So this line I'm seeing right here actually represents this edge. This line here represents that edge. This line on the back would represent this edge that runs all the way across. And of course, the front edge is right here. Now, what I want to do is use the multi-view projection technique of finding a feature in this view and seeing if I can project it forward or upward or across or wherever it needs to be. And so I can see there's lines that are going to be created by the change of where this inclined plane intersects that vertical plane. So I'm going to draw a line all the way across there. I'm going to go to this edge, project up, and draw a line all the way across there. And if I look at this top, if I'm looking straight down on this now, I'll see that in my top view. I'll see this plane in the top view. Of course, I'll see this plane in the top view, but I'm going to see these four squares also in the top view. I'm looking straight down on those. And if I project up from over here, there's the first square. If I project up from there, there's the second square. And these squares are one grid by one grid. That's the size of those. So this view here is represented by this, and we call this an inclined plane. It's running downhill from this point. It's running downhill. We're not normal to that surface. This surface here we are normal to, which means we're seeing it perpendicular to that surface. So this would be true size and true shape. We're normal to these over here. Then we have another inclined plane, which is running downhill from this point to a lower point here. That would be over here. So the thing that's missing in the top view are the hidden lines for these two holes that go through. So we're going to project the sides of those holes and the center line up to this view. And so the way we do it, we're going to go to the quadrant of this hole, which would be the farthest point on the left-hand side of that hole. And we're going to project that up, and that actually should be hitting at half a grid. And I'm going to sketch a dashed line. And that dashed line is a hidden line that represents the left side of this hole as it goes through. I'm going to go to the quadrant on the opposite side and project it up, and starting right here, I'm going to draw another dashed line that represents the right hand side of that hole that goes through this part. And to finish that, I'm going to draw a line, have a little break with a short dash, and another line, and that represents the center axis of this hole as it goes through that part. I'm going to do the same thing over here. I'm going to project up. I'm going to go to the quadrant here, project up, put my dash line in for the side of the hole. Go over here, put a dash line in. Remember, we call those dash line hidden lines because they represent the edges of hidden features. I'm going to project up my center axis. So we're drawing a center line. Remember, a center line is a long line with a little break, a short dash, another break, and then a long line like that. All right. So now all I need to do is work on my right side view. So in the right side view, I'm going to see this square. I'm going to see this inclined plane. This is actually going to be on the right side view. I'm going to see this vertical plane and this vertical plane here. I'll see the hidden lines where the holes go through. And I'll see some more. Let's see. No, I don't think I'm going to have any hidden lines over there. Okay. So here's a way that we can actually use this line that we have in our drawing. This is called a miter line. And what it is, it's a line that's drawn in at 45 degrees. And it allows us to project information from this view to the side view over here, or from the side view up and across into here. So here's how that works. If I go to this corner and I draw a light line across until it intersects my 45 degree line, again, I call this a miter line because it's like a mitered corner. If I project straight down, the back side of my part is going to lie on this line right here. And if I project from the top of the front view, the right side of my part is going to fit within this area right in here. Now I'm going to go to my front edge of the top view and project it over until it meets with that 45 degree line. And starting right there, I'm going to project down lightly like this. And so my right side view is going to fit inside those three lines right there. Now, when I look in from this side over here, and I'm looking, I'm going to see this surface and I'm going to see this surface, but there's a break between those. But I can use this 45 degree line to locate those over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to where the edge of this thing that sticks up right here, I'm going to go to that back edge. I'm going to project across to my 45, down from my 45 degree line, and I'm going to draw a line that lines that look like that. I'm going to come straight across to, that's this little line that I have here that's two grids long. Excuse me, I'm going to go to this line, project over, project down. That would be the side of this. Bring that across. Now, in looking at this, would I have a line across here and here? Well, I come over to my view and I look in this direction and I see that this line goes all the way across. So that means I'm going to have a solid line across here and a solid line across here. Now, this plane in the background is still there. And normally you would think, well, I would have hidden lines to see those, but this visible line right here takes precedence over those hidden lines. So when by precedence, I mean it covers those hidden lines up. Okay, so what else am I missing? If I look over here, I need to have this line. I can find where that line would be. It would be line up with that corner, project straight across, and draw a line across right there. That's going to be a visible line. I would see that line. Now, what about this back edge back here? Am I going to see it over here? Well, if I'm looking at this view, I have an edge in the background there that would be represented by a hidden line in this view. So I'm going to project across on that grid. And starting right there, I'm going to have a dashed hidden line. And that represents that corner right there. Now, I'm going to have two holes going through here, but those holes line up when I look in this direction. So I'm only going to see one set of hidden lines for that hole. And so what I'm going to do is go to this hole, go to the top of it, which we call the quadrant. Like I said, that should be at the half grid point. I'm going to project it across, and starting right at this edge, I'm going to start putting another dashed line in. Now, hidden lines do not extend out into space like center lines do, so don't make that mistake. I'm going to come to the bottom of this hole, find its quadrant, and project across, and draw another dashed line like this. And then all I'm missing is the center axis or the center line that runs through there. So I go up to my center line, project across. I want to start outside of that, project across like that, put a dashed line in, bring that center line out like that. And at that point, I have my views finished. From what I can tell, I'm just looking at this thing. I always review everything and see if I've left anything out. Looks like my front view is good, and my hidden lines have my holes with center lines. I think about what my top view is going to look like. I have my hidden lines for the two holes. Over here on the right hand side, I know I'm going to see this plane here. I'm going to see the holes going through. I'm going to see a hidden line for this line back here that's lower than this one is by one grid, which is what this hidden line represents right here. And then I've got these two squares that I'll see that represent these two vertical planes right there. So I believe I've got my project finished. This is figure, or actually exercise 2.1, and it's problem number 2 in the textbook. Thanks for watching.